Believe it or not, I haven't always been this successful internet lawyer entrepreneur person. Back when I was a kid in Ohio, outside of Cleveland, normal for me was, or for my mom, I should say, I was raised by a single mom. Normal for us was going to school, getting good grades, going to work, getting a job, going to college, whatever, finding a stable job at a stable firm, whatever that might look like, getting a normal paycheck, and retiring in 40 years. That was what normal looked like for my family. And that was what I was taught when I was a kid. But I'll be honest, for me, that felt incomplete. That was not the way I wanted to roll. And part of the reason for that was probably the fact that my mom was a guidance counselor in the public school system. So she made basically a fixed income. Money for us was always tight. I mean, I'll be honest, I don't ever remember a time when I was growing up where I didn't have to worry about money. Now, mind you, we weren't like starving, so we always had food on the table, but I do remember that it was always quite a struggle, the financial aspects of growing up. And being that we lived in a middle-class neighborhood where a lot of my friends came from fairly well-to-do families, I definitely noticed the difference between where I was and where they were. I wanted more for myself. I wanted to not have to worry about how I was going to support myself financially. And I certainly didn't want to worry about how anyone or anything was going to take care of me as I got older. So what I want to talk with you about today are some of the failures that I've had over the years that have led me to where I am now with Hawthorn Law. And the first failure that I can remember was my freshman year in college. I can remember like it was yesterday. I signed up with this company called University Painters. I don't know if they're still around. Basically what they did is they were out from college campus to college campus and signed college kids up to basically build their own business during the summer, go around, hire employees, give quotes for jobs. They would feed leads to these kids, and then the kids would have to basically hire all the staff and paint the houses. Pretty good deal for this company, I think. And honestly, it wasn't really a job. It was my first opportunity to build a business that I was responsible for. I'm pretty sure that had I done this, I was going to have to pay a hefty royalty or franchise fee to the parent company. But I honestly don't know, because we never got that far. My mom shut that business down pretty damn fast. She even had my uncle, who was a lawyer, come in and write them a pretty mean, nasty letter because they didn't want to let me out of this contract, and letting them know, listen, I was a college kid. My job was to get good grades, like I said before, and not to be driving 3 hours home on the weekends to figure out how I was going to paint houses for people. So they, that got shut down real fast. But honestly, that was my first taste, right, of entrepreneurship. That was the first, if I had my way, it would not have been shut down. Let's go, let's do this. I was ready to roll. I was ready to paint some houses. So I knew right then and there, I knew that with the right opportunity and the right skill set that I had, I mean, boom, I was ready to go. I could have my own business. And that was my first taste, and I wanted it. I liked it, and I wanted it bad. So let's fast forward a bit through the rest of college and law school. And I'm not gonna say there weren't some MLM. There weren't some network, what are they called? There weren't some multi-level marketing pyramid scheme things in the middle. I'm not gonna say that didn't happen. Somehow I made it through college and then law school. And as many of you know the story, when I finished law school, I worked for a firm for a couple years, and then I headed off into the wide world of hanging my own shingle. But the way I looked at this really is, as a lawyer, when you hang your own shingle, what you're doing is you're really just creating a job for yourself. Instead of working at a firm, you're working at your own firm where you're doing all the work. Probably a lot more work than I'd be doing if I was at a firm, because I got to do the admin, I got to do the marketing, I got to do the billing, I got to do the accounting, I've got to do the actual legal work, I've got to meet with clients, I got to somehow get clients, I have to do the marketing, I got to do everything. And so working for your own firm, at least when you're first getting started and you don't have any money to hire staff or anything like that, it is an incredible experience. It is a lot of work, and I did that for years trying to build up that firm. And I was honestly pretty successful at it. I did grow a nice little firm. And I still have a nice little firm because I still do that type of work. But somewhere around 2010, 2011, 2012, I started getting that itch again to do something more than just practice law. And this was about the time when the Amazon thing was getting big. And honestly, my interest was piqued. I mean, I had the entrepreneurship bug. I loved what I was doing with the law firm, but I really wanted something else in addition. And I started a business, an e-commerce business, selling compression sleeves of all things on Amazon. And that's what I did. And I ran that for 3 or 4 years actually. And we did quite well. I'll be honest, I learned a lot. I wouldn't call it a failure more so than it was. I just didn't feel like the whatchamajiggers, the margins were there for that business. So I eventually did shut that down in around 2017 or 2018 after several years. And like I said, we had some success with that. And while I was building that Amazon business, I ended up going to a couple of seminars out west for that business to learn about how to build and grow an e-commerce business. And what I found is that people realized I was a lawyer because everyone that was there was doing something else. This was a side hustle for pretty much everybody. Some people were doing it full time, but most people were doing it as a side hustle. And people started asking me about all the legal aspects of running their business. Where should they set up their LLC? When should they set up their LLC? What else do they need to do to make sure they're legally protected? And that's when I was like, ding, ding, ding. Jim, you got something here. This is good. So that was when I first realized that all this online business stuff I've been learning about, I could really put it to use as an online business lawyer. And what was funny about that, to me anyway, was the fact that this is what my mom wanted, right? You know, when I was growing up, you know, we all have our parents, they want us to do certain things with our lives. And, you know, they're so proud of us if we can become doctors, lawyers, you know, accountants, professionals of some sort. That's what our parents want for us, right? Most parents. And she, my mom, God bless her, she passed away in 2016, but she wanted more than anything for me to just join a firm, get a steady paycheck, and be happy. That's what she wanted. And I think she would have been thrilled to know that I finally have achieved that level of success and happiness as an online business lawyer building my own business. Again, I'm doing legal work, but I'm doing it in a different type of way than most lawyers do. Because I'm still a lawyer, right? But I'm also a YouTuber, I'm also an entrepreneur, I'm also building online courses and selling products that aren't directly impacted by me providing legal advice. And that's clearly unique. That's not something that a lot of lawyers are doing. And that's probably why I've achieved a little bit of success, I'd like to think, with this channel, and hopefully why I can help many of you start an online business that you've always dreamed about. Because without those legal protections in place that we all need when we're starting businesses, then, you know, you really have nothing. So by helping you get those legal protections in place so that you can build a business that truly matters, that's where the secret sauce is for me anyway. And that's what's awesome. That's what I love about this. That's what I got with this week's entrepreneurship video. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you right over here in the next video on entrepreneurship and building stuff and all those things. Take care, folks. Have a good day.